Good morning, all students. I am Professor Emma Sheikh from Computer Science Department of Red Section Samstar, Sadguru Kalki Maharaj College and Autonomous College. So, in our last lecture, we have seen the concept of journal. Now, in this lecture, we are going to understand what is the format of journal. The word journal is derived from a French word jour, which means a day. Therefore, journal means a daily record. A journal contains daily records of a business transaction, hence it has been named so. As soon as the transactions take place, its debit and credit aspects are analyzed, and first of all recorded chronologically. Chronologically means in the order they are occurred, taking place. A journal is a book of original entry or primary entry. So, let us see the format or ruling or pro forma or specimen of journal that is given here. Now, I am going to explain each column of that journal. First column of journal is date. In this column, a journal records of the year, month, date of every transaction written. The year should be written at the top. Below that, the month and date should be written. Now, the second column of journal is particulars. There are two aspects in that particulars. First is debit, second is credit. Debit account, it records the name of account to be debited. Credit account, it records the name of account to be credited. This is decided by applying the rules of debit and credit. The account to be debited always return first. The word debit is written in the front of debited account, just near the ledger folio column. The account to be credited is written on the next line, beginning with the word to, after leaving short space just near the date column. There is a space. We can see here there is a space. Just near the date column, starting with the 2, we are writing the credit side. Narration is to be given for the particular journal entry. Now, let us see what is the narration. Narration is brief explanation of journal entry. It is written in the bracket, starting with word being. So, we understand the particular column in the journal. Now, we are going to move on our third column, that is ledger folio, that is denoted by L dot F dot. It means the page number of the ledger. The transaction enter in the journal are posted to the ledger. In this column, the page number should be recorded against each and every account at the time of posting the ledger. Now, the next column is debit amount. In this column, amount of debit is written. Credit column, credit amount column. In this column, the amount of credit account is written. So, there is a pro forma, a brief description about the specimen format, ruling of pro forma of journal we had seen today. Next point is types of journal entries. There are two types of journal entries. first one is simple journal entry. Second one is compound or combined journal entry. In the simple entry, only two accounts are affected. One account is debited, one account is credited. The process of journalized entry is like the same in a profile. The another point of or types of journal entries is compound, combined journal entries. In that type of a journal entries, there are multiple accounts to be debited, or there are multiple accounts to be credited. That means there are multiple accounts in the transaction. Now let us